Well, I want to talk to you about Natalie Portman's dance double. Why is it that she's stepping forward and speaking out?
Well, she feels that she was told not to speak during the Oscar campaign to win Natalie Portman the Best Actress Award. She was told by the movie's producers not to give any interviews, and I think she felt quite insulted by that. Added to that, the fact that she and many others in the dance community took umbrage at the fact that Natalie Portman was being portrayed as an actress who had learned how to become a prima ballerina in just a year and a half. As Sarah Lane told me, it took 22 years of blood, sweat, and tears to be able to do what I do. The fact that someone would say that I can do that after just a year and a half of training was deeply upsetting.
And you learned that they superimposed Natalie Portman's face onto her body in some shots?
Yes, I mean, to be honest, the movie, the DVD of Black Swan just came out, and on the extras after the movie, you can see they show how they actually did that. So on one hand, it's a bit surprising that the movie makers are digging in so publicly about this, because it's indisputable that Sarah Lane did, in fact, act as a dance double. What they're all arguing about in this sort of unprecedented fight, and many would call unseemly fight, is the percentages or the numbers of shots that are Natalie Portman versus Sarah Lane.
It's interesting, too, because one might look at it and say she was in the credits, just like stunt doubles. They kind of work in the shadows there.
Well, the difference in this respect is that Sarah Lane is an artist of her own right. She is a superstar in the dance world. She's the creme de la creme of ballerinas. She's a soloist with the American Ballet Theater, which is one of the, if not the best, dance companies in the world. So I think many in the dance community felt like, we're not taking anything away from Natalie Portman's performance. She's an outstanding actress, and yet this outstanding ballerina is being sort of thrown under the train, so to speak. She was not given any credit in the film's credits as a dance double. She was called a hand double, lady in the lane, and one of six stunt doubles. So I think a lot of the dancers would argue what she did was above and beyond that, and she is somebody who has sacrificed, you know, her entire life for her art as well, and just should have gotten dance credit. I mean, people have pointed out that Natalie Portman in her Oscars acceptance speech thanked everybody, from the hair and makeup artist to the camera operators to the assistant director, but she did not acknowledge that there was another dancer whose body was featured instead of hers.
Does she potentially put herself at risk for any future roles in movies by coming out and speaking out?
Sarah Lane. She says she doesn't care. She's a prima ballerina. That's her career. People pay a lot of money to see Sarah Lane dance, and they won't stop doing that. The dance community is actually, I think, very much on Sarah Lane's side of this. But, it's important to note, Sarah Lane says Natalie Portman deserves her Oscar. She doesn't take any issue with Natalie Portman's dramatic performance. The one thing she takes issue with is that any insinuation that it's Natalie Portman dancing in these very difficult technical scenes is simply untrue in her estimation, that it's her body, her dancing that you see being done.
It's an interesting story, one that had a lot of us around here talking this morning. Elizabeth, thank you very much.
By the way, did you think it was Natalie Portman doing all those dance scenes?
I've got to be honest, I did. When you look at the camera shots and you see her face up close spinning around, I thought it was her.
Right. Well, in many cases, it wasn't.
Very, very interesting. Thank you very much, Elizabeth. We appreciate it.
Sure thing, Patrick.
Thank you.